Today we're looking at the TAIS Cube enclosure system from Lewden Palazzoli.
Now this looks remarkably familiar to me. It reminds me of when I was in Northern Italy at the Palazzoli factory and got the great pleasure of going backstage to have a look at their test lab, Gordon.
You did. You actually saw this enclosure getting a really good hose down under some high pressure jets to validate its IP66 performance.
I think I remember I was first in line for that jet of water before the enclosure got its covering of water.
Yeah, we did try and get you, but that's not all we saw during that visit. Check out the video if you haven't seen it, but you'll also see the kind of tests to validate the performance, such as impact test, that this kind of enclosure goes through.
Okay, so it's got an IP66 rating and you talked about its impact.
Yeah, so this is, you know, you're looking at this thing, this is a plastic enclosure. It's not glass reinforced plastic, and it is incredibly tough. IK10.
Yeah.
So that is severe. So this is built for really demanding industrial environments.
Okay, something like this then.
Yeah, okay. I pulled this out of the family album. It was a trip to a sewage works in northern Scotland I once had. And yeah, that's the kind of place you'd expect to see it, because it's not just about the IP rating.
Right.
It's about some of the other chemicals you may find in those environments.
Can you give us any examples, Gordon?
Well, we've covered water in IP66. Yeah. That's what we get tests for. But then you start to think about things like salt water, alkaline chemicals, solvents, diluted acids, UV if it's outside for sunlight, fats, oils. You know, that's just about almost every chemical known to man you can throw at it.
Okay, so that's covered the enclosure itself from your point of view, but let's think about it from the electrician's point of view.
Yeah, well, let's have a little look inside, Gary.
Okay, so can I bring in the hand cam?
Let's have a look at this. Obviously, straight in with some variants.
Okay.
So if you bring in the camera there, Gary, let's have a little look. So you first, obviously, you can have a version with a window.
Okay, yeah, a clear door, yeah.
And without a window.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
So that's the easy bit. Let's have a look at the door. The door feature, look at the door, actually goes beyond 180 degrees.
Okay, yeah.
So when you're working in this enclosure, you can get easy to get access to it. Keeps the door out of the way. Sometimes with these enclosures and the door's hanging there, someone can come back and bump it.
Yeah.
Not the hinges. The hinges themselves, recessed in from the edge.
Okay.
So it's very hard to damage the hinge itself.
Yes, okay.
Stainless steel hinges. You can actually as well remove the door.
What, take the door off then?
Yeah, so you might depends where you're installing it. You may be trapped up against the wall or something like that and you need to hinge from the other side. So it's very easy to spring the door off. Perhaps you're taking it off during first fix to keep it safe until later in the installation.
And you can hang it therefore on the other side?
Yeah, take the stainless steel brackets off and swap them to the other side of the enclosure. Yeah, and then we've sort of swapped our door over.
We can have it hang the other way. That's good.
So interesting. You notice the back plane in there as well as also that's a GRP back plane, that red plate you see in there as well.
Okay, so this means the door will be hanging the other way, so we're swapping it round. It's an effortless process. It's less than a minute in order to change the door hang. I like the way you quoted as well, you could take it off during the first fix. That's something quite clever as well. Just put the hinges back in, and there we go. You've changed the door position. Yeah.
And you'll also notice in there as well, this nice molded in seal.
Yes.
So again, that's not going to drop out and risk, you know, getting trapped and not sealing against the enclosure itself.
As I'm looking at the enclosure, I'm thinking, how am I going to fix it to the wall, Gordon?
Okay, well.
So I'll move this one out of the way.
Put that one down. So there's two ways.
So okay.
There's obviously, probably the best one is these external mountings. So you can fix these lugs onto the back of the box in two positions. So coming out the side.
Yeah.
Or also coming out the top. If you had to, you can get a mounting to put it onto a pole. You can fix through these mounting centers here that you can see marked out by the dimensions from the inside out.
Okay.
And you get a cap that obviously covers it for the IP rating, but also ensures it maintains its double insulation rating.
Oh, so it's double insulated as well?
Yeah.
Right, okay. So let's flick it over then.
Okay, you want to see the really clever bit.
Okay.
So before we go inside.
Right.
Let's think about the locks. So I'm going to bring the camera in again, Gary. Let's have a little look at that. So you can have the two versions. So this is obviously a lockable door lock.
Okay.
Or you can have it with that familiar triangular key or just an unlocked handle. So obviously it depends on whether you want people to have easy access to it or whether it actually needs to be securely locked.
But the clever stuff carries on inside, doesn't it? Talk us through this, Gordon.
Okay. So we've got, this is called the click cube. And the idea here is you can assemble, so say you were going to make this into a into a distribution board, assemble all your MCBs or contactors or DIN rail terminals off-site, then take the completed assembly and spring it into these clips. This is called the click cube system. So it just neatly drops into the enclosure, and then you can cover those with, you know, various obviously open windows to bring your MCBs out, or closed panels as well. You just fit them with a nice little quarter turn.
And I found it really easy to clip that in. And then, yeah, like you said, just a quarter turn in order to put the plates in. It's just a simple system. It's very easy to install. So very electrical friendly, that is. And then just put the bottom one in. Imagine we were going to add a few extra devices in the rest of the working day. So there you go. Yeah, and again, the door just swings closed. We can lock the door, as you've just shown us, and we're away.
That's it. I mean, so that is obviously the flexibility goes on as we get used to seeing with Lewden Palazzoli. The system's a bit like Lego. We looked at that top tier range in the past. Check out that video if you haven't seen it. But this is, I guess, this is the big brother of it. This is for those demanding applications. You can put a solid inner door in here.
So a door within a door, what's thinking beyond that?
Door within a door. Say you had you wanted a sort of another access panel. Perhaps you had some indicators in here, some push buttons that people might need to access, but you still needed another sort of layer of protection. You can have that as well.
So we touched on chemicals. What about temperature range?
So this will go incredibly from minus 30 to plus 100 degrees C.
And the enclosures themselves, what sizes they come in?
So they come in a wide range. So we've got the, what have you done with it? Where have you put the small enclosure?
Oh, right, okay, it's down here. Yep, they've got a little one there.
Yeah, so you've got one of the smallest ones in the range, but it goes all the way up to 850 by just over 1,000 millimeters. Now, to put that into something you'd probably, you know, some scale, think of MCB modules.
Okay, yeah.
Goes from 36 modules right all the way up to 200 modules.
Well, that's a big unit.
Yeah, so you can fit a lot of circuit protection in there, isolators, contactors, you know, perhaps a PLC or something like that.
So as always, we're interested in your feedback. The click cube system, what's your thinking on that? I thought it was fantastic. We love your comments below. What sort of enclosures are you using in onerous conditions? Or perhaps even name some more onerous conditions than the sewerage farm in Scotland that Gordon has. Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.